Like, comment, share and subscribe.
Donald Trump is leaving the G7 summit early and will not attend discussions climate change or ocean pollution, underlining tensions within the groups which have been stoked by U.S. trade tariffs as he appeared stony-faced at a breakfast meeting with Angela Merkel this morning. The 6+1 tone of the gathering in Quebec means the leaders from Canada, Britain, the U.S., France, Germany, Italy and Japan are unlikely to issue a joint statement as they remain sharply divided on trade and the environment to reach consensus. The two-day summit in Canada has been marred by fears of a trade war and tit-for-tat exchanges of hostile tweets, with U.S. trading partners furious over Mr. Trump's decision to impose tariffs on steel and aluminium imports from the EU, Canada, and Mexico as part of his America First agenda. But French officials have indicated the EU and US will establish a dialogue on trade within the next 2 weeks, signaling a modest step forward at G7. A French diplomat said, "The principle of a dialogue was agreed. Everyone agreed, including President Trump." Mr. Trump plans to leave the summit mid-morning on Saturday, 4 hours earlier than originally planned, to fly to Singapore ahead of his historic meeting with North Korean leader Kim Jong-un. But that means he will miss a working session among the leaders on climate change and clean energy, as well as talks among the G7 and poorer countries focused on the health of oceans. The early exit also means he will be gone before allies begin closing news conferences likely to be laden with criticism of the U.S. stance on trade and Mr. Trump's abrupt suggestion yesterday that Russia should be readmitted to the group. Russia was booted out in 2014 because of its annexation of Crimea from Ukraine. German Chancellor Angela Merkel said EU countries at the summit agreed that the conditions to readmit Russia had not been met and even Moscow seemed to reject the suggestion. Mr. Trump's presidency has been clouded by a federal investigation into alleged Russian meddling in the 2016 presidential election, and possible collusion by his campaign. Both Moscow and Mr. Trump have denied the allegations. Follow our live G7 coverage below. 6:00 PM, a picture speaks a thousand words. Angela Merkel's office has released a picture from the G7 talks showing Mr. Trump sitting cross-armed while other leaders look on sternly. Mrs. Merkel is shown towering over Mr. Trump, who is the only leader present seated. The photo could be an attempt to show just who is in control of talks, or, perhaps, whose stubbornness is holding talks back. 4:20 PM, Italy joins Trump in backing Russia. Italian Prime Minister Giuseppe Conte has said he hopes the G7 can readmit Russia as soon as possible, but Italy is not seeking an overnight lifting of sanctions against Russia. He said, "Italy thinks it is important to have a dialogue with Russia, but this does not mean that the system of sanctions can be overcome overnight. The system of sanctions is linked to the Minsk agreement, which is not fully implemented yet." 3:50 PM, U.S. stands alone on climate. An official from the French G7 negotiating team has painted a stark picture of the divide over climate change, saying, "We have six leaders on one side and the United States on the other." 3:30 PM, Trump issues warning to Kim Jong-un. Mr. Trump told reporters at the G7 summit he believed North Korean leader Kim Jong-un could make his country great, but warned him, "It's a one-time shot." He said, "I really believe Kim Jong-un is going to do something positive for his people." 3 PM, Trump makes a statement to the G7 summit. Mr. Trump has told leaders that trade is at top of his agenda for the G7 summit. He complained the US had been taken advantage of for decades and decades and said, "We can't do that anymore." The president said he had told fellow G7 nations that the US requires fair market access and end to unfair trading practices. He said he did not blame the G7 leaders for the unfair trade deals. 2 p.m., Trump arrives late for gender equality meeting. Donald Trump arrived late for the first working session on gender equality, but Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau forged ahead with opening remarks without him, commenting wryly about stragglers. The U.S. president looked uncomfortable throughout the breakfast meeting.